The Eagle Obsession, a new documentary from Future Dude Entertainment, is now in production. Here's an exclusive first look. I've been on a journey to the future since childhood. Back then, I would constantly dream of a world of tomorrow. Nothing symbolized those visions more than NASA's moon missions. The 10th man to walk on the lunar surface was one of my greatest heroes.
Well, it's great to see you, sir.
Thank you very much. Good to be with you today.
Yeah, really appreciate it. So tell me, I gotta know, like, what was it like riding in this thing?
It was a real experience. The vehicle is, you know, 360 feet long. And so you're sitting up on the top here, and once the first stage shut down, it was like a train wreck. You're accelerating at 4.5 G's, and bang, it shuts down like that. Once we got into orbit, it was on the backside of the moon, we came around from the front side, and there was Earth rise. And the first thought I had was, man, we're a long way from home. I hope this thing holds together.
Then, General Duke gave me a tour of my favorite real-life spaceship.
These vehicles don't fly like airplanes, right? They have these reactive control thrusters and everything,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, a lunar module flew like a helicopter, except it was using rocket engines instead of a rotor blade. You could go up, down, right, left, forward, back. The main engine just gave you the support that...
Keep you aloft.
Keep you aloft.
While I saw the Apollo missions as a huge triumph, I was also sad that they ended. As the moonshots came to a close, I refocused my interest in the future on the world of science fiction. A good friend of mine happens to have done the same.
If I was a science fiction writer in the 1960s and I wrote a novel that was about the human race went to the moon 6 times and just said, been there, done that, and stopped, I would have been laughed out of the genre. I mean, it was inconceivable that we would go there and then just lose interest. So I grew up as a kid in this very small town of Wisconsin. I was the only one around me that read comics and was interested in science fiction. And then Space 1999 comes on at this Chicago independent TV station, and I'm watching Moonbase Alpha and the Eagle and the mixed crew of all these different cultures and races fitting together. And I wanted that future. I want a moon base, and I want to go there.
He was right. Space 1999 was a milestone for an entire generation. I decided to explore the impact that iconic TV series had on my life. No one epitomized the show more for me than the character of Eagle pilot, Captain Alan Carter.
So here we are, 50 years of Space 1999.
Yeah, it took 4 weeks of rehearsals before we even started to shoot the first episode. The director was Lee Katzen, and he's responsible for me being in the show, because I wasn't going to be in the show. I was going to be in it, but I was going to be playing a pilot that died in the first episode.
Ah, okay.
And after we'd been rehearsing for a while, he said to me, I don't want to kill you. And I said, I don't want you to kill me either. Because I loved the idea of the show, and I really wanted to be in it, and it was a kid's dream come true.
Seeing Space 1999 as a kid, it helped me project into a future that I thought I was going to live in.
We all thought by the year 1999, we would be out there in space continually.
I grew up loving the fictional Eagle spacecraft from Space 1999. And it turns out, I'm not the only one.
The reason why I liked the Eagle so much was because it felt like an extrapolation of the lunar module. This grid work, the girders, you know, the engines.
As you said, I see this ship come on the screen, and it's like, that could be real. It makes sense.
Yeah.
It's the first science fiction show I'd ever seen with a ship that made sense.
I've treasured my Eagle toys and models since I was a kid, but there's one guy out there who puts my collection to shame.
So you're 12 years old, living in Muncie, Indiana. Mm-hmm. And where'd you first encounter the eagle?
My neighbor, Tom, he was a big sci-fi guy.
Did he have like a lot of different spaceships or different models or?
Yeah, it's hard to remember because once I put my focus on the eagle, that's all I can see.
Okay.
I was super excited to check out Todd's Corner of the Universe.
It's really something to imagine. This is sitting right in the middle of central Indiana, mm-hmm. right? And who would have ever thought that, you know, right. in the middle of all that, that you have this
cornfields
and cattle and yeah. all this, and then we've got eagles. What is this place for you?
This is my time machine. This is me in my childhood going, I wish I had all this stuff when I was a kid.
Yeah. That, totally relate. I mean, I would have lost my mind if I could have had access to this stuff when I was a kid.
Todd had built a huge network of fans. It was time to seek out more. The more I looked, the more I began to realize that Space 1999 and the Eagle had impacted people from all around the world. So I traveled across the Atlantic to meet a man who had dedicated over 4 years of his life and unleashed a myriad of creative skills to explore his love of the iconic ship.
I have to know like how this all began for you. How did it start?
In the very beginning, I was a child. Okay. And I watched Space 1999 in Danish moon base Alpha.
How old were you?
I think nine to 10 years old. And very quickly, the eagle became the main character for me. I just think the shape is perfect.
How big is what you've built? How large is it?
It's 7.5 meters long.
Okay.
I think 25 feet.
We need to see the real thing.
Yes?
Yeah, I'd like
you
to
sure?
see it. Yeah. Now, is it put together?
No, not yet.
Oh, it's not? It's not put
maybe
together?
Maybe you can help,
help
me.
I'd love to help.
A few days before I arrived, Jan and his friend Lars packed up his eagle and took it to a nearby stage.
What are these called in Danish?
It's a bolt.
Oh. Can I have a bolt?
Okay, so push. Vi skal først have splitten ned, og så sætter vi det der på først. Eller er du ready? Kan du trække den lidt ud?
Ja, det kan jeg nok godt.
Sådan der.
It took us nearly 3 hours to assemble, but the results were spectacular.
Could you have imagined yourself looking forward, you know, 5 decades in the future, that you're going to build probably the biggest one on Earth?
No, never, never.
Yeah, but then maybe you build a bigger one.
No, I can promise you that. No, no.
Seeing Jan's build motivated me to create my own Eagle project. I connected with a friend who creates some of the greatest film sets in the world.
Check this out.
It's the Eagle.
Wow.
Yeah, so we're talking, what, 1975?
So predates Star Wars.
Predates Star Wars, yeah. I want to recreate this, and I want it to be as faithful as we can get it. I have this dream of bringing Nick Tate, you know, the actor who played Alan Carter,
yeah.
and bringing him back and getting him in this thing for the first time in 50 years, which I think would be a lot of fun.
That would be amazing.
Yeah, I put this together.
You have CAD.
Yeah. Okay. I have no idea what these were. They look like ice cube trays or something.
Yeah, they probably were. They were probably sourced from some garden center that was 5 minutes from Pinewood.
Not all of my childhood heroes were astronauts. Some were visual effects artists, like the man responsible for creating the Eagle over 50 years ago. Robin's team of master set builders typically works on projects like Star Wars. Now, under his supervision, they're rebuilding this iconic set. I decided to bring Brian along to check on the progress.
When I designed the Eagle from the exterior, mm-hmm.
the cockpit was really cramped, mm-hmm. really small. Mm-hmm. And then Frank Watts, the director of photography, said he couldn't shoot in something small, so Keith Wilson turned it into the TARDIS and made this huge interior. But it worked for the movie, you know.
Yeah, it definitely works visually, yeah. Right? Does this bring back memories at all? I know it's not quite done yet, but...
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Going to be great when it's finished.
Well, I guess, again, wanted to recreate this as part of this project. Thank you very, very much for joining us and taking a look
at
pleasure.
It.
Yeah, we really appreciate it. The journey is just beginning. The full film will be available next year for the 50th anniversary of Space 1999. Stay tuned.